neutral side action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Georgia is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. Fielded at the four. Brought down at the 32-yard line. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. The stop at around the 48-yard line.
I'll tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. Gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He's taken down around the 30-yard line.
Let's give this quarterback a lot of credit. He recognized the man coverage. And guys, I'm going to tell you something. He probably knew he was going to go to the post before the ball was even snapped. Well done.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. Makes it out to about the 20.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Got the corner. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 7-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. Here's the eighth play of the series. Tight end over the middle, touchdown. The tight end does a nice job coming down with that touchdown catch.
He certainly did, Brad. This guy's a big-time threat inside the 10-yard line because of his size. He can outmuscle defensive backs for the ball.
He makes the PAT. A nice 7-play, 68-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the 6. He's out to the 30. Oh, what a hit. Georgia's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Fires incomplete. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line. To the back. Tackle made at the 28.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating. As a ball carrier, it's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over to the sideline after the series, make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
He goes downtown. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. That makes it first and 10. Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. They'll go ground, and he has it on the corner. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. That makes it first and goal. He's tackled at the 11.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From the 11-yard line, it's second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. That's a gain of 7 on the play. That makes it third and goal. He's got the corner, and he's taken down at the 3. The halfback picks up a yard. It's fourth down. This should be an easy field goal. Kicks away, and the field goal is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. From the 7. He's out to the 30. The 50. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Feeds it to the back. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Miami of Ohio is up 4. He gets rid of this one.
Flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Gets to about the 17-yard line. Fires out to his wideout. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Puts on a move, touchdown. Looking touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a six-play, 34-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Here's a running play. Tackle at the 41-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Five wide. He lets it fly. Keeps a foot in and pulls it down. We played one quarter. Miami of Ohio leads it 14-3. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Pass. First and goal coming up. He's knocked down after a big game.
That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the one. Expect to see something straight up the middle.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 30. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Miami of Ohio holds a four-point lead. Tackles him hard at the 22-yard line. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He's under pressure. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 49-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line. Pass and hit hard as he came down with it. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Number 12 was the intended.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. To the end zone, and a huge touchdown play.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play.
And he tacks on the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. At the 30. And down he goes at the 32.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer. And that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. And he just gets rid of it. From their own 32-yard line, second down. He goes out of bounds, right around the 32-yard line.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
Strike to his receiver, no good. That'll make it fourth down, and they're going to have to punt.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. He's taken down at the 43.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
He's going to go for the home run.
Big catch there as they knock him out of bounds. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. He's in trouble. Fires it out. Knocked out of bounds at about the 15-yard line.
That'll make it second and four.
With the catch and knocked out of bounds. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. He tackles him for a loss. The quarterback tried to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
He has some room. Touchdown, Miami, Ohio. Converts the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. And he's going to come up with a sack.
He has one job on passing situations, get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long.
Rose.
17, the intended receiver of the play.
They go with a run, and he's going to be stopped short.
This is a good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run, and when the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the stop.
He's tackled at the 41.
The Redhawks are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. He caught it, but failed to get that one necessary foot in.
That's an outstanding catch, and he just missed making a big-time play.
1 minute left in the first half. Caught. Big hit. He's going to lose yardage. That's a 2-yard loss.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
A screen pass, gets it to the back. He's knocked out of bounds at the 10. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks up, and he's got it. Like they're ready for the kick. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being.
And a quick throw. And down he goes at about the 35.
But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 35. He's taken down at the 49.
Not a safe pass at all. Really tight coverage and not a lot of room. Credit the receiver with going after that one and hanging on.
With the pass, incomplete.
Number 17 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Steps up, airing it out long. Almost picked off.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 41. He fires left side. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Well, that's one effective way to slow these guys down, getting a hand between the ball and the receiver.
This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He gets hit out of bounds
at about the 25-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. taken down around the 35-yard line.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
Got it. Complete, and he's out of bounds. We've reached halftime, and there's an upset on the horizon. 31-10, Miami of Ohio.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Offensive coordinators get a lot of attention in college football these days, understandably so, and a lot of innovation going on in the sport.
Yep.
I don't know if this is innovation as much as just execution and explosive playmaking.
Yeah, and there's always a rhythm and a flow to offensive play calling, and you can see them when they start to get into it, and everything just goes perfect. And right now, that's the rhythm and flow. I mean, right now, everything that they're dialing up seems to be working, and that's a special skill. It's not everybody can do it. Sometimes you get too creative and shoot yourself in the foot, but right now, passing it will, running it will, really picking good spots for both of those plays. For whether it's a run or a pass, they're picking their spots, and it's working really well.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 26. The Redhawks continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Got a man. Watch out here. He's at midfield. Good open field tackle. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. They'll bring him down at the 29-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Run up the middle.
That's a gain of 4 on that play.
From the 25-yard line. First down. Throws complete and he's hit right away.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Throws it in a hurry. He's tackled around the 11-yard line. Throw. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Here's the 8th play of the series.
Boy, the
defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. And somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They run it for the first, and he stops. They try to counter Trey there, but the defense read it nicely.
It's amazing the read and recognition skills of these linebackers. They just always seem to have a beat on the play.
Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. Georgia lines up for the kickoff. Fielded at the 4. And he's taken down at the 25. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. He sails it long.
That was really a remarkable catch. The quarterback didn't throw a good ball, but the receiver made a great play.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. And they make the stop, the 39-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
His man incomplete, and he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one, the accuracy of his throws. He's improved, but as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
And he might want it all here, and does. Doesn't get there. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Reception, look out, nobody there. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. First and goal from the 3. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. And the goal line defense digging in here. Dives, and he's down. Touchdown, Red Hawks. And a halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
He hits the PAT. A 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
And a huge contribution from the aerial attack. Boy, they had some nice big pass plays on that drive.
He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And he just got drilled. I hope they show some fight here and try to stay competitive. If you're going to get blown out, you at least want to go down swinging. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled around the 40-yard line.
That's good for the game of 14 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. He guns it to the right. And he stays in bounds, and he hauls in a big one. And that play could have gone for 6.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash.
Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Tackle made at the 22. Tackle right around the 10-yard line.
Number 9 brings his head on at the 10-yard line.
From the 10-yard line, it's first down. One quarter to go before they turn the college football world upside down. 38-13, Red Hawks. Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. Here he goes. Touchdown, Georgia.
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
He makes the PAT. So that's a 5-play, 73-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient in throwing the ball.
The ball is loose. It's scooped up.
Any turnover is big, but when you keep the other team's offense from even stepping on the field, you're making a statement about how badly you want to win this game.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive. They come out on an empty backfield. Quick pass. That's 4 yards on the play.
You know, little passes like this force the defense to start to come up. Then you can see an offense take their chances downfield later to take advantage of the defense starting to cheat up.
It's second down, 6 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Slings it, brought down, right around the 50. Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes, right around the 24-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line, 5 wide. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
Zips it to the back. He's taken down around the 18-yard line. 5, maybe 6 on that screen pass. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. The 10. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
That makes it first and goal.
They come out in a 5-wide set. And he's taken down at the 3-yard line.
Gain
brings up second and goal.
They're at the three. Second down. Just under three to go in regulation. Fires quickly. Touchdown. To the air and got the touchdown.
It's important for the confidence of your offense to score when you get that close.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. And they won't get the two. An eight-play, 62-yard drive. And they get 6 points on the board after failing the two-point conversion.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw. I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer. And that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown. The other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
Get to that quickly. They'll bring him down right around the 18-yard line. He's got it with room to run. Out of bounds at the 14.
Makes it second and six.
From the 14-yard line, it's second down. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. And that touchdown gets these guys right back in the game. We're looking at a one-score ball game now. And he adds the extra point. Well, I think I've lost track, but I think that's at least five possessions in which the offenses have scored. I don't know if anybody's going to step up defensively in this game or not. The offense couldn't hang on to the ball last time around. Let's see what happens here.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He makes it to the 42-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
With the defensive line neutralizing the blocks, these linebackers are able to come up and make plays in the holes.
Gains his way to the 33-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. He's looking for 6.
Well, that's a big-time play by the defense here to knock that football away to set up a pivotal fourth down.
That makes it 4 inches.
After a decent pickup.
Brad, that's a huge first down for this offense. At this point, the defense's only hope is they've got to try to rip that ball away from the quarterback or the running back to get the football back to their offense because the clock now is a big factor.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
That brings up second and 9.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. A little over a minute in the game. Brought down.
a tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ball game. And now the offense has got a chance to win it.
Bulldogs have to look at this somehow as a positive. Their star player had a great game. They just got to look to next week.
Yeah, it's tough anytime you lose a game to be positive, but if there is anything to be positive about, it's about that performance by this individual. He really did everything that he could do to try to win this football game. Unfortunately, the team ends up losing, but they can build to the future around his abilities for sure.